Baka, naturopath, thank you for coming back. Always appreciate people looking at the videos. Have you seen some of the other videos? There's quite a few on this channel now. I think there's well over 1,000. Right, next topic. Do high protein diets exert an influence on gut health? Well, lots of research is going out the whole time on these high protein diets. Keto diet and paleo diet. There are so many diets now that really focus on protein, but are they really good for your gut? Some studies say yes, some studies say no. So there's a guy from the National Institute for Agronomic Research in France. This very interesting doctor, Francois, I forget his surname now, but these French guys, looks like a typical Frenchman, Really suave sort of a looking man. And they conducted research when they got a whole lot of obese people. I think it was like 30 or 40 of them. And they put them on diets. So they put one group on a casein-rich diet, so a dairy-rich diet, and another group on a soy-rich diet. And they found the casein people tend to have an expression in their genes pushing towards, basically, mucus production in the gut. So extracellular matrix production, so more adhesions, more mucus. And then the soy people, when they started to study, what was happening there, they found that an increased and decreased expression in terms of the soy on the large intestine when it came to detoxification and oxidative stress. So protein foods exert different influences on the gut, depending on the bacteria that are in the gut at the time, depending on the load of the protein, depending on the nitrogen content and many other factors. But suffice to say, it's not good to eat high amounts of meat protein. New Zealand, country I live in, is ranked as one of the top countries in the world with bowel cancer, particularly for females. I believe it's because of the meat consumption. Far too much dairy and meat get consumed in this country. So I'm highly recommending you guys out there, if you have got a particular interest in keto or high protein diet, don't eat lots of animal protein, all right? I'm not a vegan, but I'm also not a person who hates meat, I'm not who really enjoys meat to the point where he eats it every day. I'm just basically trying to get you guys to see common sense here that meat consumption is okay, but it's not good to eat meat all the time, 2 or 3 times per day. It will change the gene expression in your gut. It will upregulate inflammation over time. It will push you towards more dysbiosis and problems. I've seen too many people eat red meat and large amounts of pork and beef and end up with serious bowel problems. So my recommendation is for you to use common sense. In England several years ago now in the UK, the recommendation was for people to eat no more than 250 grams, which is about 10 ounces of red meat per week, not per day, per week. All right. They believe the bowel cancer rate could be cut by half just by people eating a lot less red meat. So that just goes to show, doesn't it? Protein is good, but when excess protein can be bad and leads towards a lot of problems. The other issue which you need to be careful of with high protein diets is the kidney burden, because kidneys don't like high protein. And even if you're drinking plenty of water, you need to be careful with kidney function. So if you have kidney issues, my recommendation is to back off the meat and to go for a lighter kind of protein, particularly fish protein, over the red meat kind of proteins. So there you have it. Don't forget to click on the link below. Thanks for tuning in.